Hello friends, this is J. Balakrishna. Are you interested in learning the uses of has in English language? Well, in this video, I am going to tell you about the uses of has, how this person is going to help us in making some sentences in English language so that we can learn sentence formation skill and start speaking in English language. Well, coming to this person called has, he is an important member of English language. We call him has, and he indicates present tense. We use it only to talk about present tense, and he has four friends. He goes only with four people. He does not go with all types of people. He is very choosy. He goes with he and she and it and any singular name. It can be living thing or a non-living thing like this. He has, she has, it has, James has, or car has. He, she, it, name. This is called third person singular. In English language, we call it third person singular, and this indicates present tense. Use this in making sentences. If you remember this carefully and if you do not violate this rule, then you are said to be good at grammar. This is called grammar. I repeat, has indicates present tense. You can use it for four people: he, she, it, or any singular name. Now, how many sentences can I make? Now, you can make sentences to talk about possessions. He has a car. He has a farmhouse. He has a brother. He has a sister. He has a cell phone. All these are called possessions of this person. So when you want to talk about the possessions of these four people, you have to make sentences like this. Take subject, take has, and keep on adding new nouns here. He has a car, he has a farmhouse, he has a brother, he has a sister, he has a cell phone, he has a bike, he has a two-wheeler, he has a four-wheeler, he has membership, he has confidence, he has courage, he has intelligence, he has patience, he has energy, he has excitement. In this way, take large number of nouns and make sentences. You can use all types of nouns, singular and plural. He has books, he has cars, he has friends, he has parents, he has brothers, he has sisters. These are all plural nouns. You can use singular noun. He has good memory, he has sharp memory, he has intelligence, he has experience, he has energy, he has excitement. So make more and more sentences with the help of nouns. Once you become good at sentence formation, then you go to second stage to learn variations. You should know how to make use of every sentence in four different ways. Let us see how they are going to help us in four ways. Now look at these sentences. He has books. He has books. This is a verb. It goes with third person singular, he, she, it, and James or any singular noun. Now this is the possession of this person. He has books. He has friends. He has cars. He has chairs, he has tables, he has pens. Now this is in positive form, affirmative form. Now I want to learn how to convert this sentence into negative form. He has. Use does not have. He has, he does not have. This is very important for non-native speakers because they often get confused and mess up the things. So be very clear, be slow, but be very correct. He has, he does not have. 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 In this way, you have to repeat it hundreds of times with keen concentration. Close your eyes, repeat it, repeat it, repeat it hundreds of times. Then you will never forget this rule. He has books, he does not have books. Positive and negative statement. Now I want to learn how to make questions. I take the help of does. Why not do and did? Why only does? Because I am dealing with third person singular. He, she, it, and any singular name, they go with does. Does he have books? This is a confirmatory question. I am putting this question to confirm whether this person has books or not. Does he have books? Yes, he has books. No, he doesn't have books. The negative form. Doesn't he have books? Don't you have common sense? Don't you have patience? The way we use for do or don't and you, we are using it for third person. Does he have books? Doesn't he have books? Now repeat all the four sentences at a time. He has books. He does not have books. Does he have books? Doesn't he have books? He has money. He does not have money. Does he have money? Doesn't he have money? He has experience. He does not have experience. Does he have experience? Doesn't he have experience? He has confidence. He does not have confidence. Does he have confidence? Doesn't he have confidence? He has patience. He does not have patience. Does he have patience? Doesn't he have patience? Later on, replace he with she, then it, then any singular name. Collect more and more nouns. Make one sentence in the beginning, then immediately convert it into four forms and repeat them as loudly as possible. So in this video, we have seen how to use has to talk about possessions. Thanks for watching this video. This is J. Balakrishna. Hi friends, this is J. Balakrishna talking to you. In this video, we are going to discuss the uses of has, H-A-S. He is one of the most important words in English language, and we can make sentences if we know how to use this person in English language. You can call him a verb in English language, and he indicates present tense. You can use him to talk about present tense. And he goes with four types of subjects: he, she, it, or any singular name. Let us say James. He has, she has, it has, James has. So make it a point, you have to use it only for these four types of subjects. Even if by mistake, even if in hurry, if you are using it for anybody else other than these four, you are making a big grammar mistake. So be careful, you have to use it only for these four people. This indicates present tense. Now how to make sentences with this? So look at these examples. He has to go. He has to come. He has to read. He has to write. He has to learn. What do these examples indicate? He has to go. He has to come, he has to read, he has to write, he has to learn. She has to go, she has to come, she has to read, she has to write, she has to learn. It has to go, it has to come. James has to go, James has to come, James has to read, James has to write, James has to learn. So you can make sentences in this way. This is called subject. This is called verb, has form of the verb, and this part of the sentence, we call it to infinitive. Make use of more and more infinitives and make sentences like this. This is called sentence formation skill. But when should I use this type of sentences? You should use them when you are talking about obligations. Obligations meaning compulsory actions. These are the compulsory actions to be done by these people either today or tomorrow. He has to go today, he has to go tomorrow. He has to come now, he has to come tomorrow. He has to read now, right now, he has to read later on. He has to write, he has to learn, he has to understand. They indicate obligations or compulsory actions of a person. In the first stage, make large number of sentences like this. Then after that, try to learn how to make variations, how to convert them into positive and negative form, question forms. You have to learn that so that you can get more freedom, more flexibility to talk to people in English language. Now let us discuss the variations of these sentences. Now let us see one more part of the same sentence. He has to be strict. He has to be silent. He has to be punctual. He has to be disciplined. He has to be strong. Now here, this is called subject, and we are taking has. As I have already told you just now, you can use it with he, she, it, and any singular person. Now earlier we used to base. Now we are using to be. This is to infinitive. So you can use to base if you are going to talk about the actions. If it is not an action, if it is something else, then you should take the help of to be and make sentences like this. He has to be strict. He has to be silent. He has to be punctual. He has to be disciplined. He has to be strong. These are called adjectives. These are called adjectives. Now you can use not only adjectives but nouns also. He has to be a pilot. He has to be a cardiologist. You can use prepositions. He has to be at home. He has to be with us. He has to be on leave. You can use adverbs. He has to be here. He has to be there. He has to be upstairs. He has to be downstairs. He has to be abroad. So this is another way of making sentences with has. I repeat, take has, put any one subject like he, she, it, and any singular name, add to be here. You can add an adjective like silent. You can add a noun like pilot. You can add a prepositional phrase like at home or an adverb like here. Then you can make more and more and more sentences like this. He has to be decent. He has to be dignified. He has to be disciplined. He has to be dedicated. He has to be determined. He has to be active. He has to be alert. He has to be enthusiastic. He has to be energetic. So if you collect more and more nouns, adjectives, prepositional phrases, place adverbs, then you can make sentences like this. After making large number of sentences, after practicing more and more sentences, try to learn how to practice the variations also. I'll tell you how to make the variations with each sentence. He has to be silent. This is called affirmative form. Now I'll tell you how to make the negative form of this sentence. He, and take the help of does. Third person singular, so you should take the help of does. Then not, not, then I do not need has anymore. I put have here. So this is very, 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 very important. This is one troublesome area for many non-native speakers who often go wrong here. in hurry, in confusion. Sometimes they say, he don't have, he doesn't has, he has not, he have not. They get confused. So to avoid that, before making sentences, take 1 or 2 days time or 3 days time. Just concentrate on this part. Repeat, repeat large number of times. Repetitions are very, very important. He has, he does not have. Close your eyes, concentrate. He has, he does not have. He has, he does not have. He has, he does not have. And if you have a good cell phone, if it has a recording facility, when you repeat this hundreds of times, record it. Whenever you have some leisure, keep on listening to it. By listening and by oral drilling, you can remember the structures easily for a very long time, or rather forever. He has, he does not have. He has, he does not have. He has, he does not have. Once you become familiar to this, then try to make the sentence. He has to be silent, he does not have to be silent. Look at the sentence, we are not making any changes. This person, he as it is. To be silent. This is the only one area we are making change. So you have to be very careful. He has to be silent, he does not have to be silent. He has to be with us, he does not have to be with us. He has to be a cashier, he does not have to be a cashier. He has to be there, he does not have to be there. Now let us see how to make the question form. Bring him here. Does. Then bring him here. He comes here, because when does enters the sentence, has goes away. Either has or does. Any one person should be there. Here does is absent, so has is present. Here does is present, so has is absent. So these two people, they don't get along with each other. Any one of them should be there in the sentence. Does he have to be silent? Does he have to be silent? Negative question form, you can make it in two ways. Doesn't he have? Doesn't he have to be silent? Or does he not? Does he not have to be silent? So these two parts also you have to repeat large number of times. Does he have? Doesn't he have? Does he have? Doesn't he have? Because non-native speakers often get confused here. They often say, does he has? Or does he? Does he has? No. Does he have? Does he have? Does he have? Doesn't he have? Doesn't he have? Doesn't he have? Does he have to be silent? Doesn't he have to be silent? Does he have to be here? Doesn't he have to be here? Does he have to be at home? Doesn't he have to be at home? Does he have to be the next captain? Doesn't he have to be the next captain? In this way you have to make sentences. Let us try with one more example. She has to be simple. She does not have to be simple. Does she have to be simple? Doesn't she have to be simple? She has to be active. She doesn't have to be active. Does she have to be active? Doesn't she have to be active? Now I should use these sentences when I am talking about obligations, compulsory. For example, he has to be silent, meaning it is compulsory for this person to be silent. When should I use this one? He does not have to be silent, meaning it is not compulsory, it is not necessary for this person to be silent. It is not necessary, it is not compulsory for this person to be silent. Now these two questions I am using to confirm. We can also call them yes, no questions. Does he have to be silent? Meaning, is it compulsory? Is it necessary for him to be silent? Doesn't he have to be silent? Is it not necessary? Is it not compulsory for him to be silent? So these are the meanings of these two questions. Let us repeat once. He has to be silent. He does not have to be silent. Does he have to be silent? Doesn't he have to be silent? She has to be with us. She does not have to be with us. Does she have to be with us? Doesn't she have to be with us? So this is the way of making use of has to talk about obligations. So friends, I hope you all have enjoyed this video. So practice, practice, practice. Make large number of examples. Let me tell you orally, do not use pen. We use pen only to explain, only to teach. But when you practice, when you understand the concept, use tongue more than pen. That is the secret of learning English language. Thank you for watching this video. This is Jay Balakrishna. Hello friends, this is Jay Balakrishna. In this video, we are going to discuss the completed actions with present results. That is how to use has, to talk about the completed actions where we are discussing the results of those actions. Take a look at these examples. He has gone. He has taken. He has borrowed. He has won. He has invited. This is the way to make the sentences. Here we are taking three parts. This part is called subject. This part is called verb. And gone, taken, borrowed, won, invited, they are called past participle forms of the verbs. Subject has past participle form. Now what is this has? It is an important verb in English language. You can call it an auxiliary verb or main verb. Terminology does not make any difference. All that you need to know is how can I make sentences correctly with has and where should I use those sentences. Now we are going to discuss how to make sentences with has and where to use them. Take subject. Now how many subjects can go with has? You can use he, she, it, any singular living or non-living thing like James or car. He has gone, she has gone, it has gone, James has gone, car has gone. This is about subjects. Then has. Has indicates present tense. You can use it to talk about present tense. Now these are past participle forms of the verbs. All these are completed actions. Completed actions in the sense actions are over. But why do we call them present tense? Because we are discussing the results of the actions, present results of the past actions. For example, he has gone to school. I should say this sentence when the boy is at school now. He has gone to church. Right now he is in church. He has gone to market. He is in market now. He has taken tablet. I mean to say that just now the medicine has been taken by this person. He has borrowed the books from the library. The books are with this person. He has borrowed 4 books from the library, meaning 4 books are with this person. He has worn white shirt. He has worn white shirt. The meaning of this sentence is white shirt is on his body right now. He has worn white shirt. Please call that boy. He has worn white shirt. Who is that boy? He has worn yellow shirt. Who is that girl? She has worn blue dress. So he has worn white shirt, meaning the shirt is on his body. He has invited the president of India. He has invited the president of India. The meaning of this sentence is before the function. The function has not yet taken place. The function is going to take place tomorrow or day after tomorrow or next week or next month. Tomorrow we are going to celebrate the annual day of our college. So he has invited the president of India to be the chief guest. that invitation has some validity. So there you have to use this type of sentences. Completed actions, but you are talking about their present results. He has parked his car in the cellar. The meaning of this sentence is the car is in the cellar right now. He has switched on the lights. The lights are on. There is light in the room. He has switched off the lights. The room is dark. There are no lights. He has cut his finger. It's bleeding. There is injury. He has cut his finger. Please bring some cotton, water and bandage. He has slept. The person is in sleeping position. He is in deep sleep. He has slept. Talk slowly. This is how you have to use these sentences. And by the way, English grammar calls it present perfect tense. I have not introduced this term at the beginning of this video. We have learned how to make a sentence and when to use that sentence. But now, for the sake of traditional conservative teachers, we are calling it present perfect. It is not necessary for you to remember, and even if you remember the terminology, it doesn't make any difference, because the important thing for you is to make sentences in large number and use them in your language. So after making sentences like this, immediately practice variations. He has gone. He has not gone. Has he gone? Hasn't he gone? How to make four forms? I'll show you now. Take a look at these sentences. She has taken it. She has taken it. This is called affirmative form. Let us make the negative form for this. She has not taken it. She has taken it. She has not taken it. She has taken it. She has not taken it. Repeat it 10 or 20 times. Then you go to the question forms. Question forms, it's quite easy. Bring him here. That's all. Has she taken it? Has she taken it? What about the negative part? Hasn't. Hasn't she taken it? That's it. This is the way of making four variations for one sentence. She has taken it. She has not taken it. Has she taken it? Hasn't she taken it? She has taken it. This is positive form. She has not taken it. This is negative form. I'm trying to confirm. These two questions are used when you want to confirm. Has she taken it? Yes, she has taken it. No, she hasn't taken it. Hasn't she taken it? No, she hasn't taken it. Yes, she has taken it. So this is the way of making four variations. He has gone. He has not gone. Has he gone? Hasn't he gone? It has burst. It hasn't burst. Has it burst? Hasn't it burst? He has spoken. He has not spoken. Has he spoken? Hasn't he spoken? She has given. She hasn't given. Has she given? Hasn't she given? So this is the way of making four parts with each sentence. This will give you more flexibility, more freedom, more confidence of talking in English language. Thanks for watching this video. This is Jay Balakrishna signing off.